In this video, let's see this format of a question, px plus q dx over or upon ax square plus bx plus c, which is an under root. So how to evaluate the integral of this format? So we have a question in front of us to understand for the same. We will be dealing with lambda and mu, which are very much known to you till now. You've studied a lot about those. These are just simply the things that we are going to study about. So lambda and mu will acquire different values, and because of that we will integrate. So this is the question. Evaluate integral of x plus 2 dx upon under root x square plus 5x plus 6. So how to do it? What we are going to do is we will resolve this numerator, which is a linear, into some different thing. And what would it be? Let's see. For this format, this is a general format, I would like to explain that you will resolve the numerator such that it is lambda times the differentiation of the denominator plus mu. This is how we are going to do it. And then you will compare lambda and mu with the left hand side, that is px plus q. What will it happen? We will see later. But this is the procedure, right? Now the other thing. If here it is under root, here you will not put under root. Here only in differentiation you will put what is the thing that is inside the root, right? So let's start with the solution. We are going to write solution, and I'm starting with the solution. So I will resolve the given numerator, x plus 2 is equal to lambda times the denominator differentiation. So I write dash, which means differentiation, plus simply mu. Now let me again solve it further. x plus 2 is equal to lambda times, here it is 2x plus 5 plus mu. Now let's compare. So it becomes 2 lambda is equal to 1, comparing with the x coefficients, then it is 2 is equal to 5 lambda plus mu. Now what is the value of lambda from here? Lambda is equal to 1 upon 2. What is mu from here? When I put lambda, that is 1 upon 2, I can easily get mu. So 2 minus 5 by 2, it is minus 1 by 2 is mu. Now why have I done this? Basically I know that upon in the under root is very troublesome. So I'll be using certain things such that I can easily solve it further. Because I know substitution method, but directly substitution doesn't go. Because here it is x plus 2, here it is something else. Now when you have lambda and mu, you know that you did it just to solve it a bit further, right? So my numerator now changes and my integral sign I is there, here also it is I, x plus 2 is nothing but lambda multiplied 2x plus 5. So it is lambda multiplied 2x plus 5, as you can see this is how you evaluate, plus mu, so plus mu means minus 1 by 2. And denominator is not going to change. We have only done certain changes to the numerator. So this is 2, right? And the denominator is simply same, x square plus 5x plus 6. And here even dx doesn't change. Let me write this 2 very much clearly for you people. So it is going to be 2. 1 upon 2. Now, after you have done this, 1 upon 2 is there, right? You can see that you can separate certain things. So let me separate, it is 1 upon 2 outside, then 2x plus 5 is there, in the denominator is x square plus 5x plus 6, and here it is dx, that is done. Then is minus 1 by 2 going to be there, then it is dx upon again under root, x square plus 5x plus 6. Now let's move to the other side of the board for it. We are moving to the other side of the board for the further part of the solution. It is 2x plus 5, which is nothing but the differentiation of x square plus 5x plus 6. So if I write, put x square plus 5x plus 6 is equal to t, then 2x plus 5 dx is equal to dt, right? So it is nothing but equal to 1 by 2 integration dt over under root t, right? Minus 1 by 2, and what am I going to do? I have dx upon under root x square plus 5x plus 6. This type of a question we have already done, this form we have already studied. We need to complete the square for the further part of the solution. So it is going to be dx upon under root x square plus 5x plus 6. Then the half of the coefficient would be 5 by 2, its square would be 5 by 2 whole square. So it is going to be plus 5 by 2 whole square. Right? And let me remove this thing that we have written here, because now you have at least understood this part. And now let's move to the other part. It is going to be minus 5 by 2 whole square, that is minus 25 by 4. Now, see, it is 1 by 2. T raised to the power minus 1 by 2 integration is T raised to the power 1 by 2 upon 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2 integration dx upon x plus 5 by 2 whole square, right? Then it is 6 minus 25 by 4, which is going to be minus 1 by 2 whole square, and under root does not go. Now you have 1 by 2 multiply by 2 multiply by t raised to the power 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2 dx upon under root x square minus a square. The formula would be log, right? Log x, the same thing, under root x square minus a square. So you can just write the simplified form, x square plus 5x plus 6. And plus c can be written. Now, since you have already put the value over here, let me put the value over here as well. T raised to the power 1 by 2, t was what? T we had substituted somewhere, and that t was x square plus 5x plus 6. So it is under root x square plus 5x plus 6 minus 1 by 2 log x plus 5 by 2 plus under root x square plus 5x plus 6 plus c. And that is going to be the answer. So this type of a format, now you have understood. I hope you can easily solve the problem based on this.